We can't undertake the same kind of strike against Islamic terrorists in Lebanon and Syria that the Israelis undertook against the PLO in Tunisia. And there's every reason why we should have done so long ago. I think it's about time we quit BSing and started getting some things done here.
You mentioned something about terrorists go after a certain employees of jobs?
No, it's just that traditionally you respect teachers, clergymen. They're just off limits, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Civilians, it seems to me that if you have a complaint against the government, you should take a government official.
Sure. And the cost of violence, how would you raise the cost of violence?
I'm not sure how exactly we'd do that. I guess there'd be some sort of trade commission who'd be in charge of distributing ammunition and whatnot, and setting the prices.
And if the terrorists get them from the Soviet Union and through channels in that such manner?
Well, I think the Soviet Union wouldn't do that because they recently have been experiencing terrorist attacks that they've never had before. And I think they're wise to it, that if they don't sell them guns, there won't be any terrorism.
Okay. Do you have any viewpoints?
I'd like to get back to the death rate and the... Well, I have a death quote rate. Myself. Authorities variously describe the relatively low death toll of the last 22 months to a pause of terrorism as they complete their next moves, or to a series of fortunate outcomes from acts of terror, the results of which are not always predictable. And I have another one over here. Now as never before, religious institutions and religious figures, even the Pope, are targets for terrorists. Hotels and schools are being hit with, you know, frequently.
Shannon,
that's another. It's not always government, you know.
Is this proof that terrorists are hitting schools and government?
Oh yeah.
Policies?
That's good information, but I'd like to argue that it's outdated. I believe that first study you referred to is from December of 1982.
Okay, then now,
what does it have to do with?
Okay, what if this happened between December of 82 and time now,
even
April 82?
Even someone like myself, who doesn't normally keep up with the news, knows that terrorist attacks are on the rise.
What's
They're on
one?
The upswing.
And you don't keep up with the news?
No, but I'm certainly aware of it. It's all around you. You can't help but hear about it. Everywhere citizens go, they're being attacked, held hostage, bombed. Airports are being bombed. All we need to do is just one wiping out of all the terrorists, and they will learn.
No,
their
you're going to have more than one wiping out.
All right, we'll have several.
You're going to be killing people monthly. I mean, massive people.
And hopefully it will slow down the terrorists until finally there are no terrorist attacks.
What it's going to do is make a goal for terrorists to see who can get farther and who can get the most people and who can get more out of what government.
You think so?
It'll be like a game. I do.
You think terrorists have a goal?
Yes.
Caitlin?
Usually they have a list of demands that they'd like.
Do you think there'll be more terrorists who want more goals that are spreading all over the world?
You mean if we
if you keep forcing them, they'll be going resorting to different areas?
I don't think so. I think they'll just learn that the United States is not to be messed with.
Okay.
Get back to the killing again. That's my biggest point. It costs money. This war.
We have to defend our country.
These weapons.
This is war.
People complain about, you know, how much defense spending we're doing. It's not just buying nuclear arms to keep up with Russia. It's so we can kill terrorists, you know?
Okay. We might as well use them.
We're going to keep spending
them.
More and more.
We'll be back after these messages, our closing statements from Shannon and Caitlin. Please stay tuned.
They're going to waste. If we use them against terrorism...
Keep buying them. Keep buying more and more. We got to keep them.
That's right. So we might as well use them.
But if we use them, we're going to have to buy more and more.
This is fun.
Hello, and we're back with the conclusion of our show. Shannon Mackie and Caitlin Trueman have their closing statements on terrorism.
Go for it.
Thank you, Shannon. I think these two quotes I have here speak for themselves. They say all I want to say. I was struck by the marked absence of U.S. action of any kind, in contrast to Reagan's promise of sharp retaliation for acts of terrorism abroad. That quote's by international terrorism expert Louis René Bears of Purdue University, and Johann H. Alexander of the Center for Strategic and International Studies, who agrees that Iran was involved in the hijacking, urges a tough line, quote, unless this country draws the line, it's going to be increasingly targeted and perceived as a paper tiger, end quote.
Shannon.
Thank you, Caitlin. You read that awfully well.
Thank you.
I have nothing to read. Like I've been saying, you shouldn't be killing people. You should try to use justice. You know, it's just plain. You shouldn't try to kill people before even working things out.
May I interject?
And terrorism is not going to stop. This is my time of the day, okay? You can interject after this. It's just plain to, why should we kill before we even try to work things out? You know, that's all.
We're trying to, it's the American way, reason before fight.
Yeah.
I think, Shannon, that you say use justice, use the law. Well, in countries like Libya, where they harbor fugitives, we cannot get terrorists extradited. We cannot bring them to our country and try them. They can just go to Libya and go on vacation.
So it is the people's choice.
The law cannot be used in that instance.
Our people's choice and other people's choice to go to those countries and take the chance of...
No, the terrorists, what I'm saying is the terrorists have a haven there. They can't be extradited and brought to our country for trial. So the law does not work that way. We've just got to nuke them all and let God sort it out.
Thank you very much. I would like to thank Shannon Mackie and Caitlin Trueman on today's edition of SK Roundtable on terrorism. Please watch the next edition of SK Roundtable. I'm your host, Terrence Calvin. Thank you very much.